Let's write down few words first. So before we start, let me take pen. Okay, yeah, this is fine. So okay, Neem. So for those who have not heard of Neem, Neem is a name of tree, which is found in Indian subcontinent, I think, and I'm not sure if it is found in other parts of the world, but it is one medicinal tree that is found over here. Especially it acts as a natural insecticide. So previously, back in the days, grains were covered with dried neem leaves so that they can last longer, that can, they can be stored for a longer time. So neem, the word neem comes from Indian language word, I think from Hindi or Sanskrit it comes, and the word in Hindi is neem, or rather it is written in this way. So this is same as pronouncing neem. And now this another word, okay, I'll just write it here. Okay, so this word is limbo. Its pronunciation is limbo. If we have to write in English, then it can be written something similar to L-I-M-P. So this is limbo. Now we'll look at another word which sounds like this word. So it is So here you may notice that in this word limbo and this word, so here this part is, we can say in English it can be written as K-A-D-U. So it is kadu limbo. So the word kadu means bitter, and I think in Hindi it is kadwa. So kadu limbo is the word kadu is bitter. And the thing about this limb is, so if you take some neem leaves and eat, you will clearly sense that it has a bitter taste. And limbu, the word limbu is another word, or we can say it is a Marathi word for English word lemon. So lime or lemon that is bitter is kadulimbu. And that is a neem in English and Hindi as well. So now let's take a step further and try to see connection between these words. But before that, I'll add something over here. Okay, so that's okay. So this seems fine. Okay. So first let's focus on this word neem and text. Let's take a highlighter. Okay, so a neem, so this neem here, so if this is a chart of sounds where Devanagari characters, we can see in this column these are Devanagari characters and corresponding English transliteration, we can say that is how to pronounce them, is mentioned in the adjacent column. And the thing about this chart is that the sounds which are pronounced or produced similarly are grouped together in the same row or the same columns. So let's see where we find this knee on the sound. So okay, so it is in dental. Just a minute. In this row of dental sound, okay, so here it is, this is the n sound. Okay, and now let's take the li sound. So this is li, and let's see which row it is. Okay, so all the way here, and yeah, here it is, li, l sound. So here we can see n as well as L, both are in the same row, and naturally, as they are in the same row, or rather, because they are pronounced similarly, they are placed in the same row. So, in a way, we can say that the words limbo or neem both were formed from the same root, and later, due to sound interchanges, particularly the interchange between N and L sound, these two words got separated, or from one word, two words were formed. So, that was about N and L. Now, let's see if the same can be applied to M and B. So, I'll take some another color. Okay, so here M. M can, yeah, so M is here in the labial row. So, this is M. And we have covered M. M, M sound. Similarly, for B or the B sound, we can see that it too is in the same row. Okay, sorry. Okay, it was here, it's B. So again, because these two sounds are pronounced similarly, they are placed in the same row. That is, we can see B as well as M are pronounced, are present in the same row of labial sounds. So from this, we can understand that due to certain changes in the sounds, or maybe the way certain people heard or heard differently, the M or B sound got swapped, and here N and L sound got swept. So these so that was about neem and limbu, and kadulimbu, which in Marathi, so this is a Marathi word, and in particularly the limbu or the lemon that is bitter is kadulimbu, whereas in general we can we have an idea that lemons are sour fruits. Okay, so that was about it, that is these two sound interchanges and these two sound interchanges. Now what about lemon? So if you look at lemon, so here we have L part, it is lay and this is li, or lem and lim, because this point dot shows that it's lim. Okay, so lim and lem sound a bit similar, and okay, so on part is a bit different. So it's possible, I'm not saying that it is the case, but it is possible that the word lemon and limbu are related to each other, maybe historically some way. I had read that the word lemon comes from Arabic word, so let's just okay. And here, so if I write lemon, you can see that the English transliteration of this Arabic word over here, you can see the spelling is lemon. So I'm not sure how it is pronounced.
Lemon.
So it says lemon. So that is how it is pronounced in Arabic. And if we again then change to Marathi, then you can see that lemon and limbu both are a bit similar in pronunciation. So not necessarily they have the same origin, but at least phonetically they sound similar to each other. It is possible that they originated differently, but they sound similar phonetically. Okay, so that was about it. So let's conclude something. Okay, I'll just erase this all up first. And let's go for text itself. Let's just So we have a word, first name, then we have okay, I'll just write the other one. So here we can say that so here N part, so these words are obviously related to each other, because this word comes from this word, that is the English word neem comes from the Hindi word neem, and the words, these two are clearly related to each other. and the part of this limbo part, this word is also related to this possibility to sound interchanges that we can see over here. That is this N, L, and B and M, and then lemon, which is we are not sure if these two are related. I mean, I don't have any concrete proof to support it, but at least phonetically they sound similar to each other. So that was all about how these four words, that is Neem, Kadolimbo, Limbo and Lemon, are in a way related to each other. And there's also another word called Idlimbo. I'll write it Ida. Which is another word in Marathi. So especially if you are a little kid and teachers tend to teach this Devanagari letters to kids, then at that time they say E for Idlimbo. So it is a larger form of citrus fruit. So let's see what is its English word. Just type over here. Okay, so it is unable to find it. So, but I'm sure on the internet it is a larger fruit as compared to lemon. So, okay, so what it says is it's a medicinal plant which is found in India, and it is a form of lemon itself, and its fruit is a bit larger, or rather quite large as compared to lemon. We'll see if there are any images of it. Okay, yeah, so here it is. So this might look like a lemon, but it is larger as compared to normal lemons that we get in India. So that was about this video. Yeah, thank you for watching.